Hello friends, in last lecture we solved example number 10, now we'll continue. So next question I'm taking from page number 652, page number 652, example number 11. Example number 11, the question is, in a triangle, if the angle bisector of any angle and the perpendicular bisector of the opposite side intersect, prove that they intersect on the circumcircle of the triangle. Okay, so we have to prove that in a triangle if the angle bisectors and the perpendicular bisector of the opposite side. So suppose we have a triangle. Okay, this is the angle bisector. Okay, and the perpendicular bisector of the opposite side. In a triangle, if the angle bisector of any angle and the perpendicular bisector, so let me take this triangle. Okay, angle bisector and perpendicular bisector. Okay, then this point we have to prove definitely is on the circumcircle of the triangle, that we have to prove. So let us see, let me draw the diagram first and then let me explain you that how we have to prove. Definitely we will draw first a circle. Okay, now perpendicular bisector of this is the triangle ABC. Now if I draw the perpendicular angle bisector of this, okay, let this is the angle bisector. Now this is point Q. Okay, this is triangle ABC. AQ is the bisector of angle A. Okay, AQ is the bisector of angle A. Now what I have to prove, that perpendicular bisector of this segment BC. This is the point Q. Now what actually I have to show, the perpendicular bisector of BC, perpendicular bisector of BC and angle bisector of angle A meet at a point and that point lies on the circle. So what I am doing, I draw the bisector of angle A, let it meet the circle at point Q. Then this is the O and what I did, I joined this OQ. Now, if I want to prove this, that means the perpendicular bisector of the opposite side and the angle bisector of angle A meet at the circle. for that it is sufficient to prove that this line segment is the bisector of or perpendicular bisector of BC. Okay, I hope you are getting this thing. What I did, I took triangle ABC, I draw its bisector, let the bisector of angle BAC meet the circle at Q, then next what I did, I joined OQ. Now in order to prove that the perpendicular bisector of opposite side and the angle bisector meet at the circle, it is sufficient to prove that OQ is perpendicular to BC. Okay, so now let me give you its proof in a proper way. Given what we have given, triangle ABC is the O comma circle O comma R is the circumcircle of triangle ABC, or is the circumcircle of triangle ABC. To prove what we have to prove, that angle bisector of A and the perpendicular bisector of BC meet at the, to prove angle bisector of angle A and perpendicular bisector of BC meet at circle O comma R, that we have to prove. Okay, that we have to prove. So let us see how to prove. Okay, so construction, a small construction is required. Construction, draw a bisector of angle BAC, let it meet the circle O comma R at Q. Okay, let it meet the circle at Q. That is, I can say angle BAC is equal to, angle BAQ is equal to angle CAQ. Angle CAQ is equal to X. As this is the bisector, I took this as X. Now further, join OQ. Now we will see its proof. Okay, before I proceed, let me explain you once again the question. Question want to say that if I draw the bisector of angle A and if I draw the perpendicular bisector of BC, definitely they meet, as well as they meet at point Q. So what I did, I draw the bisector of angle A and I suppose that it is meeting at the circle point Q. Then I joined OQ. I'm not saying I'm drawn perpendicular bisector. I joined OQ. Now if I am able to prove that BQ is perpendicular to BC, I can say definitely the perpendicular bisector of BC and the angle bisector of angle A meet at Q. Okay. Now in order to prove that bisector of angle A and perpendicular bisector of AB, perpendicular bisector of BC meet at circle O comma R, it is sufficient to prove OQ perpendicular BC. Okay, so now my aim is to prove OQ perpendicular BC. Now join BO and CO. Join BO and CO. Now you can see this arc BQ subtends angle BOQ at the center, and this arc BQ subtends angle BAQ at the remaining part of the circle. Join BO and BQ. Now arc BQ subtends angle BOQ, angle BOQ at the center and angle BAQ at the remaining point of the circle. Therefore I can say, okay, so further I am writing over here. Therefore angle BOQ is equal to twice of angle BAQ, that is twice of x. Similarly I can say that QC, okay, let it be first one. Now CQ, in the similar way I can say CQ subtends angle COQ at the center. See why I am doing so. Actually I have to prove this OQ is perpendicular this. Okay, that means I need to prove this angle is 90 degree. Okay, and for that I need to prove these two angles are equal. For triangle, let this point is D, then actually I have to prove ODC is congruent to ODB. Okay, and for that this is the common line, this is the these are two radii. Okay, BO and CO are the radii. This, now I need to prove these two angles equal so that I can prove the triangles congruent. So I am trying to prove BOQ equal to COQ. So here BOQ is twice of x, COQ is also twice of x, so definitely they will be equal. Here I proved BOQ equal to twice of x. Similarly I will prove COQ is equal to twice of x. So okay, now CQ subtend angle COQ at the center and angle CAQ at the remaining part of the circle. Therefore I can write angle COQ is equal to twice angle CAQ, that is equal to 2x, let it be second. From first and second I can say angle BOQ is equal to angle COQ. Therefore I can say angle BOD is equal to angle COD. Okay, here you can say in construction, draw bisector of angle BAC, let it meet circle at OQ. Okay, join OQ. Here I can write let OQ meets BC at D. That is the construction part. Okay, so here I got angle BOD equal to COD. Let it be equation number 3. Okay, let it be equation number 3. Now what I can do further, now I can prove these two triangles congruent, BOD and COD. So now in triangle BOD and COD, now in triangle BOD and triangle COD, okay, BO equal to CO, reason, radii of सेम सर्कल, सेम सर्कल बी ओ इक्वल टू सी ओ. नाउ बी ओ डी इक्वल टू सी ओ डी वी प्रूव्ड इन थर्ड. एंगल बी ओ डी इज इक्वल टू एंगल सी ओ डी फ्रॉम थर्ड, फ्रॉम थर्ड. ओके, एंगल बी ओ डी इक्वल टू सी ओ डी एंड ओ डी इक्वल टू ओ डी कॉमन. ओ डी इज इक्वल टू ओ डी कॉमन. So here these triangles are congruent. Okay, so first of all note it down, then I will give you the remaining solution. However, it is almost done. Here I proved the triangles are congruent. As the triangles are congruent, I can say angle BDO is equal to angle CDO. This is not 90 degree that we have to prove. Okay, these two angles are equal. Then my linear pair, their sum will be 180. Both are equal, so each will be 90 degree. As I say angle BDO 90 degree, definitely I can say OQ perpendicular BC. Okay, and that is sufficient condition to prove what we actually need to prove. So note it down, then I will give you the remaining solution. Okay, I will give you this once again. Okay, note up to this point. This is equation number 3. After this, we'll prove the triangle congruent separately. So, note up to this part. So after this, the remaining portion I am going to solve over here. Okay, BOD equal to COD. So now in triangle BOD and triangle COD, BO is equal to CO, that is radii of the same circle. Okay, therefore these two will be equal. Then angle BOD is equal to angle COD that we proved in third. So from third, then OD is equal to OD, that is common. Therefore I can say triangle BOD is congruent to triangle COD by side angle side. Therefore, I can say angle BDO is equal to angle CDO. Let it be fourth. Okay, now angle BDO plus CDO is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because of linear pair. Now एंगल बी डी ओ प्लस एंगल सी डी ओ इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. देयरफॉर एंगल बी डी ओ प्लस एंगल सी प्लस एंगल बी डी ओ इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. ओके, रीजन बिकॉज बी डी ओ इक्वल टू सी डी ओ. एंगल सी डी ओ इज इक्वल टू एंगल बी डी ओ फ्रॉम फोर्थ. ओके, फ्रॉम फोर्थ. देयरफॉर ट्वाइस एंगल बी डी ओ इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. देयरफॉर एंगल बी डी ओ इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री. एंड हेंस आई कैन से ओ क्यू परपेंडिकुलर. ओके, देयरफॉर ओ क्यू परपेंडिकुलर, ओ क्यू परपेंडिकुलर बी सी. एंड हेंस आई कैन से दैट बाइसेक्टर ऑफ एनी एंगल, देयरफॉर बाइसेक्टर ऑफ एनी एंगल एंड परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर एंड परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर ऑफ अपोजिट साइड मीट एट सर्कम सर्कल ऑफ द ट्रायंगल. मीट एट द सर्कम सर्कल ऑफ द ट्रायंगल. हेंस प्रूव. ओके, सो नोट डाउन दिस रिमेनिंग पोर्शन, देन वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. Okay, so now we'll see the next question. Next, that is question number 12th from same page number, that is 652. Question is, if the bisector of the opposite angles P and R of the opposite angles P and R of a cyclic quadrilateral PQRS intersect the corresponding circle intersects the corresponding circle at A and B, at A and B respectively, then prove that AB is the diameter of the circle. Then prove that AB is the diameter of the circle. Okay, you have to prove AB is the diameter of the circle. Okay, let us see how to prove. It is given if the bisector of opposite angle of a cyclic chordal PQRS. So first of all, we'll have to draw a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so this is the circle. First of all, PQRS. So I'm taking this as PQRS. Okay, now bisectors of opposite angles, that means bisector of angle P, this meets the circle at A, and the bisector of angle R, this meets the circle at bisector of angle P. And bisector of angle R in this way, bisector of angle R. This, so we have to prove this AB is a diameter of the circle. Okay, so we draw the diagram in a proper way so that AB at least looks like a diameter. Okay, this is point A, this is point B. Okay, so this is the diagram. We have to prove this AB is the diameter of this circle. Okay, so let us see how to prove. Okay, given what we have given, PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral, okay, that is given. Now further it is given PA bisects angle SPQ, angle SPQ. Okay, then RB bisects angle SRQ or QRS. Okay, we have to prove that AB is the diameter of the circle. Okay, so let us see how to prove this. Okay, a small construction is required. See, the purpose is that we have to prove angle ARB equal to 90 degree. If I am able to prove ARB 90 degree, definitely AB will be the diameter, because we know angle in the semicircle is 90 degree. So for that I need this angle, so I will join this. So in construction, join AR. Also we have to join AS. That is actually, I think, not required. Let us see if it is required later on, then I will include over here. Now proof. See, now target is that I need angle ARB to be 90 degree. So and we also know that SRQ, this complete angle, okay, this I am taking angle 1 and this I am taking angle 2. I need to prove ARB equal to 90 degrees. So I will start angle SRQ, angle SRQ plus angle SPQ plus angle SPQ is equal to 180 degree. Why? Opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Okay, now half of angle SPR or SRQ by 2 plus angle SPQ by 2 plus 180 by 2, not plus, is equal to. Now half of angle SRQ, half of angle SRQ is angle 1. So when I wrote over here RB bisects angle SRQ, that is I can write angle SRQ by 2 is equal to angle 1. So here I will write angle 1. Now SPQ by 2, that angle SPQ by 2, here I can write angle 2, get 3. Okay, SPQ by 2. Now angle 2 and 3 further I am going to make equal. This is angle 2. So here I can write, that is angle SPQ by 2 is equal to angle 2. So that is angle 2 is equal to 90 degree. See, it is almost done. Now I can say angle 2 equal to angle 3 because these two angles are in the same segment AS, isn't it? This AS substance angle 2, AS substance angle 3 as well. So at the place of angle 2, I can write angle 3. Before that, here I have to write the reason. So angle SRQ by 2 is equal to angle 1 and angle SPQ by 2 is equal to angle 2 given. These two informations are given. Okay, therefore angle 1 plus angle 3 is equal to 90 degree. Now angle 2 is equal to angle 3, reason, angles in the same segment, angles in the same segment, and the name of segment is SA, angles in the same segment SA, that's why they are equal. Now 1 plus 3 equal to 180, that means angle ARB is equal to 90 degree. Therefore AB is a diameter. Hence proof. So please note it down, then we will see the next question. Okay, here I forgot to write to prove. So here you can add that thing, to prove AB is a diameter. Okay. So now Now next we will see example number 14th. Okay, so this is the next question. In the given figure, we have x upon 3 equal to y upon 4 is equal to z upon 5. We have to find the measure of x, y and z. So see, there are so many methods by which we can find the measure of x, y and z. But first of all, as the ratio is given, we can find x, y, z in terms of a single variable. So solution, x upon 3 is equal to y upon 4 is equal to z upon 5, therefore I can say x equal to 3k, y is equal to 4k and z is equal to 5k. Now anyhow I have to connect x, y and z. So see, this angle, there are so many ways by which we can do this. So this angle A, I can say it is equal to x, because this ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, and angle DCQ, that is y, is an exterior angle for this. We know exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to interior opposite angle. So A will get in terms of x. Now D we can find again by the exterior angle property of triangle in DCQ. So I will get this angle in terms of XZ, this angle X. Now for this triangle I have all three angles, so now I can apply the angle sum property of the triangle. So first of all I will obtain the angle A. So angle BA D, or here it is only one angle, one point is there. So now I can write angle A is equal to angle DCQ, angle DCQ, therefore angle A is equal to X, therefore angle A is equal to 3K, or let it be X only. Now reason behind this, exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral, exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to its opposite interior angle. Okay, so that is the reason behind this. So we got angle A. Now angle ADP, now angle ADP is equal to, angle ADP is equal to, angle ADP, or better to write, now angle CDP, angle CDA, not CDP, angle CDA is equal to, angle CDA is equal to angle DCQ, angle DCQ plus angle DCQ plus angle CQD plus angle CQD. Reason, exterior angle property of triangle. Okay, so here I can write, therefore angle CDA, angle CDA, or here at the place of CDA I can write CDP is equal to X plus Z. Now in triangle APD, in triangle APD, by angle sum property of triangle I can write angle A plus angle CDP, CDP plus angle APD, plus angle APD is equal to 180. Now angle A we obtained already, that is X, CDP is X plus Z, and APD is Y, is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, now at the place of X I can write 3k, at the place of Z I can write 5k, at the place of Y I can write 4k, is equal to 180 degree. So this gives you 15k is equal to 180 degree, and hence I will get the value of k. Therefore k is equal to 12. Okay, k is equal to 12. Now what I need to find x by that. Now x is equal to 3k, that is 3 into 12, 36. Y is equal to 4k, 4 into 12, 48. And z is equal to 5k, 5 into 12, 60. Okay, so 36, 48 and 60. Okay, so please note it down, then we will see the next question. Okay, now let us see the next question. Okay, next is example 16th, page 655. Example 16th, page number 655. Prove that any four vertices, prove that any four vertices of a regular pentagon of a regular pentagon are concyclic. Okay, so first of all you must understood what is the meaning of regular pentagon. Okay, regular pentagon, I hope you are understanding. Okay, is a closed figure made up of lines having five lines, pentagon. Now it is regular, that means all its angles are equal. So Let us see how to prove this. So first of all, I have to draw a regular pentagon. Okay, something like this is a regular pentagon. If I name it, okay, it is like regular pentagon is A, B, C, D, E. We have to prove any four vertices. Okay, so I'm changing it name little bit. I'm starting from this A, B, C, D, E. Now I will try to prove its four vertices, that is A, B, C, D are concyclic. A, B, C, D. So what I have given A, B, C, D, E is a regular pentagon. Okay, to prove A, B, C and D are concyclic. Okay, so how to prove that is it's a concyclic? See, there are so many ways to prove a quadrilateral is concyclic. The very first thing, we can prove the sum of opposite angle is 180 degree. That means if I join AD for a while and I prove this angle and this angle, sum of this angle is 180 degree, then I can say these four points are concyclic. This is the one way. Another way, see, we had a theorem. Theorem was like, if line segment joining two points subtends equal angles at two other points such that the points are on the same line, then four points are concyclic. Okay, we had this theorem that here, if AB subtends equal angle at C and D, that means if these two angles are equal, we can say these four points are concyclic. So here, we'll try to prove. Suppose if I join this, and if I join this, now if it is possible to prove these two angles have equal measurement, then we can say these four points are concyclic. So actually, this is a question, looks like it's related to circles, but actually it's a question of congruency. Now, ultimately, now I came to the point where I need to prove these two triangles are equal. Now, to prove these two angles are equal, it is sufficient to prove these two triangles are congruent. Now, if we talk about these two triangles, this BC is common. Okay, BC is common. And this AB is equal to CD because it's a regular pentagon, that means all its sides are equal. Now this angle S is all sides are equal, also its all angles are equal. So even though we do not have the measure of angle, we can say all its angles are equal. So these angles are equal. So these two triangles are congruent by side angle side, which gives me this angle 1 is equal to angle 2, and hence we can say these four points are concyclic. So let us see its proof. A construction is required. Construction: join ACBD, join AC and BD. Now its proof: in triangle ABC and triangle DCB. In triangle ABC and triangle DCB. And triangle DCB. AB equal to CD, AB is equal to DC. Reason here, all sides of regular pentagon, even though it is not pentagon, it's a polygon, still I can say all sides are equal. All sides of regular pentagon are equal. Okay, now angle ABC is equal to angle DCB. again the reason all angles of regular pentagon are equal. Here again instead of pentagon I can say polygon. All sides and all angles of regular polygon are equal. Now next, BC is equal to CB, that is common. Therefore I can say triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DCB by side angle side, and hence I can say angle 1 equal to angle 2 by CP CT. Now here I will describe but angle 1 and 2, but angle 1 and angle 2 are subtended by subtended by BC at points A are subtended by segment joining B and C at points A and D respectively. Therefore A comma B comma C comma D are concyclic. Hence proof. Okay, so please note it down, then we'll see the next question. So after this we'll see the next question. Next question that we are going to solve is example number 17 from the same page, that is page number 655. In an isosceles triangle ABC, with AB is equal to AC, a circle passing through B and C intersects the sides AB and AC, the sides AB and AC at D and E respectively, at D and E respectively. Prove that DE parallel BC. Prove that DE parallel BC. Okay, so there is an isosceles triangle ABC. Now, it is given that AB equal to AC. We have given in triangle ABC, AB is equal to AC. Okay, now a circle passes through B and C, a circle which passes through B and C intersects AB and AC at D and E. AB and AC at D and E. We have to prove DE parallel BC. Okay, that means a circle is passing through these four points. So I'm imagining a circle in this way. A circle is passing through these four points. That means we can say these four points are actually concyclic. Okay, so we have to prove DE parallel BC. To prove DE parallel BC, the very first thing that comes in my mind that if I able to prove these two angles are equal, I can say these two lines will be parallel. So yes, these two angles are equal. See, let me draw a smaller diagram over here. Actually, what this question want to convey that we have something like this. Okay, ABC is a triangle, isosceles triangle, and there is a circle which passes through B and C, intersects AB and AC at D and E. This is the actually diagram, we can say. Okay, so you can draw this diagram as well with this. Now here what we have to prove. Okay, it's better to draw this diagram only. Okay, then it will be easy to prove. We have to prove DE parallel BC. So see, this angle are equal. Okay, let me say these are X, and by exterior property of the cyclic correlator, this angle and this angle will be equal. So these two will be equal. So definitely lines will be parallel. So let me draw the diagram once again. For that I need, see, it is not possible to draw first triangle and then circle. So first definitely I have to draw the circle, and then according to the given condition I'm going to draw the circle. Okay, this is triangle ABC. No doubt it looks like it's a diameter, but it is not a diameter. So I'm not taking this now. It is, this point is D, this point is E. So now you have to prove DE parallel BC. So given triangle ABC with AB equal to AC, a circle is passing through B and C meets AB at D and AC at E. Okay, so what we need to prove, we have to prove that DE parallel BC. DE parallel BC. It's very easy to prove. So let us see how to prove. So first of all, in triangle ABC, AB equal to AC. Therefore, I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Therefore, I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Okay, why AB equal to AC? It is given. Why angle 1 equal to 2? In a triangle, angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Because of that, I can say these two angles are equal. Angle 1 equal to angle 2. Let it be equation number 1. Now let this is angle 3. I'm saying this is angle 3. Okay. Now angle 3 is an exterior angle for cyclic quadrilateral DBCE. Therefore, I can say angle 3 is equal to angle 2. Angle 3 is equal to angle 2. Reason, we can write in a cyclic quadrilateral exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to its opposite interior angle. Exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to its opposite interior angle. Okay. Now from first and second, definitely we can say angle 1 equal to angle 3. Okay. From first and second, angle 1 is equal to angle 3. But these angles form a pair of corresponding angles with DE and BC. Therefore, DE parallel BC. Hence, proof. So, please note it down. Then we will see the next question. Now, let us see the next question. Okay, next question I am taking from page number 656. Page number 656, example number 21. Okay, in the figure, P is a point on the side BC. P is a point on the side BC of a triangle ABC such that of a triangle ABC such that AB equal to AP such that AB is equal to AP through A and C through A and C lines are drawn parallel to lines are drawn parallel to BC and PA respectively BC and PA respectively so as to intersect at D so as to intersect at D. Show that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Prove that quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so diagram is given. Okay. P is a point on side BC of triangle ABC. So, this is triangle ABC. Okay. This is triangle ABC. P is a point on triangle ABC such that AB is equal to AP. Such that AB is equal to AP. Such that AB is equal to AP. It is given. Okay. Now further it is given through A and C lines are drawn parallel to BC. Through A a line is drawn parallel to BC and through C a line is drawn parallel to PA. Parallel to PA. They meet at point D. Okay, so we have to prove that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so let us see how to prove this. See, to prove ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, we need to prove some of it opposite angle is 180. This is the one of the way. That means I have to prove 1 plus 2 equal to 180 degree. Now it is given that these two sides are equal. However, they are not looking equal. So let me take in this way that this is point P. Okay, this is B, this is point P, so that they look alike. Okay, and hence I have to make changes over here as well. Okay, okay, now it is okay. Now I have to prove sum of these two is equal to 180 degree. So first of all, this AD is parallel to BC given, DC is parallel to AP given. So this is a APCD is a parallelogram. So I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. We have to prove ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. That means I have to prove 1 plus 3 equal to 180. So it's done almost. So given what I have given, P belongs to BC of triangle ABC such that AP is equal to AB. Okay, then AD parallel BC, then CD parallel AP. Okay, to prove टू प्रूव क्वाड्रिलेटरल ए बी सी डी इज अ साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलेटरल, दैट वी हैव टू प्रूव. सो नॉट दैट मच डिफिकल्ट. लेट अस सी हाउ टू प्रूव दिस. कंस्ट्रक्शन इज नॉट येट रिक्वायर्ड. If I say this is angle 4, so first of all I can say 3 equal to 4, isn't it? Then 2 plus, first of all 2 plus 4 is equal to 180, linear pair. At the place of 4, I can write angle 3, 2 plus 3 equal to 180. At the place of 2, I can put 1, so 1 plus 3, 180, hence proof, isn't it? I started with 2 plus 4, 180. Linear pair. At the place of 4, I kept 3 because 3 equal to 4. So 2 plus 3, 180. Now at the place of 2, I kept 1. Why 1 equal to 2? Because A, P, C, D is a parallelogram and opposite angles are equal. So 1 plus 3, 180, it means A, B, C, D is a cyclic quadrilateral. So let us solve it in a stepwise. First of all, I will prove angle 3 and 4 are equal, then 1 and 2 are equal. So in triangle APB, AB equal to AP, that is given. Therefore angle 4 is equal to angle 3. Let it be first. Reason: in a triangle, angles opposite two equal sides are equal. Okay, now AD parallel PC. Now in quadrilateral APCD, in quadrilateral APCD, AD parallel PC and AP parallel DC given. These both are given. Therefore, quadrilateral APCD is a parallelogram. As soon as I say it's a parallelogram, I can say therefore angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Let it be second. Opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay. Now angle 2 plus angle 4 is equal to 180. Reason: linear pair axiom. Therefore, at the place of 2, I can put 1. 1 plus 4 is equal to, or let it be 2 only. At the place of 4, I am putting 3 is equal to 180. Angle 3 is equal to angle 4 is equal to angle 3 from first. Therefore, now angle 1 plus angle 3 is equal to 180. So angle 2 is equal to angle 1 from second. Okay, so now 1 plus 3, 180. 1 plus 3, 180 gives you ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. But these are the opposite angles of quadrilateral ABCD. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Hence, proof. Please note it down. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट वी विल सी क्वेश्चन नंबर एग्जांपल नंबर 23 पेज नंबर 657 पेज नंबर 657 एग्जांपल नंबर 23 ओके सो दिस इज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट वी हैव टू सी सो क्वेश्चन सेज वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट द एंगल बाइसेक्टर ऑफ द एंगल्स angle bisector of the angles formed by producing the opposite sides of a cyclic quadrilateral intersect at right angles. That means if we have a cyclic quadrilateral, let the cyclic quadrilateral is ABCD. Now, if we produce its opposite sides, if we produce its opposite side, then let the angle obtained R, Q and Z. So what we have to prove? The angle bisectors of angles of what which angles those angles which we obtain by producing the opposite sides of a cyclic quadrilateral it is given provided that they are not parallel but obvious if they will be parallel we won't get the angles by producing the opposite side that means if the opposite sides are parallel then definitely we won't get these angles so here it is also you can say information is given that the opposite sides of a cyclic quadrilateral are not parallel. Now, when we produce, so when I produce DA and CB, they meet at Q. Similarly, when I produce AB and DC, they meet at Z. Now, question says that we have to prove the angle bisector of these two angles. So, let me draw the angle bisector of these two angles. And we have to prove that these two angle bisector meet at right angle that means if I say this point is O so in short I have to prove QO perpendicular ZO or angle QOZ is equal to 90 degree okay that means this angle is 90 degree as well as this angle 90 degree we have to prove so now for that according to the concept of the congruency what very first thing that came in my mind that if it is possible that these two angles are equal okay if these two angles are equal then their sum will be 180 because it's a line and then each will be 90 degree now to prove these two angles equal what I need to prove these two triangles congruent okay this let the point is M and let the point is N So I have to prove angle MOZ is equal to NOZ. Okay, that we have to prove are congruent. Now, here we suppose this is angle 1 and this is angle 2. Let me say this is angle 3 and angle 4. So simply 1 and 2 are equal. If you talk about these two triangles, definitely angle 1 and 2 are equal. As well as I can say this MZ is common. Now, anyhow, I need to prove one more angle of these two triangles. Equal then by proving the triangles congruent I'll be able to prove these two angles are equal by CPCT and with the help of linear pair I can say each will be 90 so let us try to prove one of the angle of these two triangles equal okay now this I have to prove 90 degree that means it is not possible to prove these two equal so I am taking these two angles that I have to prove equal okay so let us see how to do this okay 1 2 3 4 okay now suppose I say this is angle 5 so can I say this angle will be equal to this angle 6 exterior angle of a quadrilateral is equal to the opposite interior angle okay so I can say these two angles will be equal suppose this is angle 8 and let this angle is 9 sorry let this angle is A and this angle is B that I need to prove are equal so if I say triangle QAM एंड ट्रायंगल एम जेड ओ, एम जेड ओ, ट्रायंगल एम जेड एंड ओ, इक्वल टू 4, 5 इक्वल टू 6, सॉरी 1 इक्वल टू 2, 3 इक्वल टू 4, See, if I say triangle QAM, in triangle QAM and triangle QCN, triangle QCN. Okay, I'm talking about this triangle QAM. Okay, and triangle QCN. I'm talking about these two triangles. So, in triangle QAM, we have angle 3, which is equal to angle 4 of triangle QCN. Then this angle 5 is equal to angle 6. If I say this is angle 6, isn't it? 5 equal to 6. So, but obviously the remaining angle of this triangle, that is, let this angle is 7, will be equal to the remaining angle, that is B. Okay, or if I say let it this be 8. Isn't it? Again, I'm explaining in triangle QAM and QCN. 3 and 4 are equal, 5 and 6 are equal, so but obvious remaining angles 7 and 8 will be equal. But 7 equal to 9, 7 equal to 8, 7 equal to 9, that means 9 equal to 8. So in that way, we can say these two angles will be equal. Now let us see how to write it in a proper way. So first of all, I do write what is given. So what we have given, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral that we, that is given. Then DA and CB produce to meet DA and CB, and CB produced produced to meet at Q, to meet at Q, AB and DC produced, AB and DC produced, produced to meet at Z. Now QN bisects, QN bisects angle DQC, angle DQC, that is angle 3 is equal to angle 4, then Z X or Y, whatever you say, or simply I can say Z, okay, Z X, Z X bisects angle AZD, angle AZD, that is angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Okay, that's it. That is given. Now what we have to prove, to prove QN perpendicular, we have to prove QN perpendicular ZX. Okay, so okay, construction is not required over here. Now let us see its proof. So actually in triangle QAM and triangle QCN, in these two I will apply the angle sum property and I will obtain the value of angle 3 plus 5 and over here 4 plus 6. So in triangle QAM by angle sum property of triangle, by angle sum property of triangle, I can write angle 3 plus angle 5 plus angle 7 is equal to 180 degree. Okay, now therefore at the place of 3 I am writing angle 4, at the place of 5 let it be write that only plus is equal to 180 degree. Here I do write the reason angle 3 is equal to angle 4 given. Okay, then angle 4 plus angle 6 plus angle 7 is equal to 180. Here angle 5 is equal to angle 6. Reason exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to exterior angle of cyclic quadrilateral is equal to its opposite interior angle. Its opposite interior angle. Okay, so 5 equal to 6. So let it be equation number 2. Okay, or actually I need let it be equation number 1 only, that is not required. Now I will apply the angle sum property in triangle QNC. Now in triangle QNC, by angle sum property of triangle, in triangle QNC by angle sum property of triangle, I can write angle 4 plus angle 8 plus angle 4 plus angle 6 plus angle 8 is equal to 180 degree. This is the second. From first and second, see, first and second both are equal to 180 degrees, so they must be equal to each other. So angle 4 plus angle 6 plus angle 7 is equal to angle 4 plus angle 6 plus angle 8. So 4, 6 here cancel out, so ultimately we'll get angle 7 is equal to angle 8. Let it be equation number 3. Okay, now next what I will do, now I prove these two triangles, no, still something is left. Okay, let it be equation number 3. Okay, now angle 7 is equal to angle 9. Now angle 7 is equal to angle 9. Let it be fourth reason, vertically opposite angles. From third and fourth I can write angle 8 is equal to angle 9. Let it be fifth. Now I need this to prove these two triangles congruent. 1 equal to 2 already given. Okay, OZ is common and 8 equal to 9 all we proved. So these two triangles will be congruent. So I can say these two angles will be equal and their sum will be 180. So each will be 90. So note it down up to this point, then we'll see its remaining solution. Okay, so let us see how we'll prove it further. Okay, now in triangle MOZ and triangle NOZ, angle 1 is equal to angle 2 given, एंगल 8, एंगल 9 इज इक्वल टू एंगल 8 फ्रॉम 4th, ओके सॉरी फ्रॉम 5th एक्चुअली, दैट इज फ्रॉम 5th एंड साइड, दैट इज एम जेड ओ इज इक्वल टू जेड ओ, जेड ओ इज इक्वल टू जेड ओ, दैट इज कॉमन. सो वी कैन से ट्राइंगल्स विल बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट बाय, ट्राइंगल्स विल बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट बाय एंगल एंगल साइड. देयरफॉर ट्राइंगल एम ओ जेड इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू ट्राइंगल एन ओ जेड बाय एंगल एंगल साइड. Therefore, I can write angle MOZ. Therefore, angle MOZ is equal to angle NOZ. Angle NOZ. Let it be 6th by CPCT. Now angle MOZ plus angle NOZ is equal to 180 degree reason linear pair axiom. Therefore, angle MOZ plus angle MOZ is equal to 180 degree. We proved MOZ and NOZ are equal. So here I do write angle MOZ is equal to angle NOZ from 6th. Okay. Therefore, twice angle MOZ is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle MOZ is equal to 90 degree, and as soon as I say MOZ equal to 90 degree, I can say QN perpendicular ZX, hence proved. So please note it down, this remaining portion. Okay, so that is all about this lecture. Now we meet in next lecture. Till then, bye. Thank you. Take care. Stay at home.